So earlier this week, I posted on my WordPress account a blog entitled Lonely Versus Loved. And this was something that's really been laid on my heart over the past few weeks, just from doing self-evaluation and talking with friends at college, to see that loneliness is something huge that so many of us struggle with. However, it's one of those topics that people don't like to talk about. And anyone who knows me knows that I am very open with my struggles, maybe to a fault. I need to keep some stuff to myself. But I just believe that the Lord allows us to feel certain things and go through certain things so that in turn we can reach other people and encourage others. And so I was sitting on my bed earlier this week, and my roommate was out of town, and it was like 2 in the morning, and I couldn't sleep. And that's a prime opportunity for the Lord, for us to turn to the Lord, but instead sometimes we allow other whispers to come into our mind. So I was sitting there and I started feeling lonely, and I started listening to the lies of Satan saying that I wasn't loved and that I wasn't worthy. Living in a dorm, you can hear everything. And so I walk up and down the halls and I hear girls in rooms laughing and having a great time together, and I'll go downstairs and there'll be a couple sitting together at the tables being all lovey-dovey. Or you walk on campus past the caf and there's groups of friends hanging out. And this is something that I struggle with so much, is feeling lonely, feeling left out, feeling not worthy and not loved. And it's something that I just have to sit back sometimes and say, Madison, you were being ridiculous. I literally walked around campus today with a shirt that says loved, because I just believe that it's really important for me to remind myself and, to have this reminder that I am loved. It's okay if I have to sit by myself. It's okay if I'm spending Friday and Saturday nights, in my dorm room. But it's all about a choice, and it's about the choice to believe the lies that Satan tries to slip into our mind somehow. And so I just was thinking, and I wrote about this in my blog, like, what are some of the lies that other people believe? The lies, when you're laying in bed at night and you can't sleep and you start to, think about things and overthink things if you're anything like me, or the lies that you start to believe about yourself when you walk past that friend group that looks you up and down and doesn't seem friendly, There's so many different lies that are easy for us to believe about ourselves. But I believe this main one that we believe is that we're not loved or we're not worthy of love. And so I honestly have no idea what I'm talking about right now. This is just words coming from my mouth, from my heart, just that I just want to encourage other people to see how loved they actually are. It's okay if you don't have a best friend, and it's okay if you don't have a friend group. It's okay if you're not the most popular kid in school, or if you eat by yourself sometimes. That has no determination on your self-worth and who you are. I'm going to go all churchy and saying that you had a Savior that died for you, and He loves you, and you have a family that loves you, that brought you into this world. And some of us have a family that, adopted us or picked us up, and they love us. That was a choice that they made to bring you into their lives. And so on days when I'm feeling lonely, I think it's so important to fight these lies with Scripture. The Lord says that He is with us always. He says that we are fearfully and wonderfully made. He says that He is there for us when we are tired and need rest. And I think that's such an important element for me to remember on days when I'm feeling by myself, that I'm never by myself. The Lord is always there. And even if I look around and all I see are people with friends and boyfriends and girlfriends and I'm just sitting alone, like, that doesn't mean anything, because this is not eternal. And I am loved. Even though I may not have, that group or that special friend, like, I'm not alone. Like, the Lord is with me every day, and I've been placed on this earth to encourage others and minister to others. So as I was just sitting here thinking and praying, I just feel like that's a very big thing that's been laid on my heart that I want to encourage others with, is that you are loved, and I am loved, And sometimes we just need that simple reminder in the midst of chaos. So I hope you could use that today and encourage someone else with that truth.